1 year ago, I acquired a social disease, and in the next 10 minutes, I'm hoping you will get it too. Forewarned is forearmed. Our story begins with what it's all about. This is young Shay, and as you can see, she's missing the fingers on her right hand, but at this moment, she's teaming up with a member of e-NABLE to try on this 3D-printed prosthetic hand given to her for free, and she likes it, and she smiles, and is this just the best thing ever, or what? Our story begins when this South African carpenter on the right cut the fingers off of his hand in an accident, discovered that prosthetics are unbelievably expensive and virtually unavailable if you've got a good hand but no fingers. And he teamed up with Ivan Owen, a prop maker and puppeteer in the Pacific Northwest, and together they designed a 3D printable prosthetic hand. Richard Van Az, the carpenter, made a YouTube video 1 year ago, which I found, and in it he mentioned that he had discovered that his invention would also help the approximately 1 in 2,000 children who were born missing fingers or hands or wrists, that he was open sourcing the design. And suddenly I perked up, because a year earlier I had been at a conference of the National Collegiate Innovator and Inventors Alliance, and I went to not one but two talks in which engineering professors reported that they'd taken a team of engineering students, teamed them up with someone who needed a custom prosthetic, and together, by the end of the year, the client had a new custom prosthetic and a changed life. The students felt great. The professor gave them an A. And after the second of these presentations, I asked a question. It occurred to me that if they had one person who needed a custom prosthetic in their hometown, there were probably another 100,000 people around the world who would benefit from the very same basic design. Did they have any way of disseminating, distributing these, making these available to other people? Their answer was, well, actually, no. The projects go into a filing cabinet, the students go and get jobs, and I start preparing my next course. I immediately had a grandiose and complicated vision for a multi-university consortium that would collaboratively develop, disseminate these designs, allow students to add to them, and of course also make use of an emerging network that was anticipated of 3D printers. But you know, if you're familiar with academia, you know that getting even one university to agree with itself is impossible. And after a few months, I gave up. But when I saw this video 1 year ago, I did something simple. I took 20 minutes rather than preparing my own course, and I created a Google map, and I added a comment to the YouTube video saying, if you have a printer or need a hand, put yourself on this map. Because as you know, YouTube video comments are rarely inspirational, but in this case, I saw two comments saying, you know, I got a printer, I would do this. So I called their bluff and they called mine. I had set up a simple map and I described it as a global volunteer assistive technology network built on an infrastructure of electronic communications, 3D printing, and goodwill. And this, I think, may be a really important recipe. Within 6 weeks, we had 70 people on the map, and it actually began to work as fantasized. Here's the story. People become aware of a 3D printed hand. They go to a website called Thingiverse. They download this thing, and what they actually get is a 3D model, which they can customize to fit the needs of a particular individual. They then use a 3D printer, which is basically a glue gun on a mechanical arm that lays down really thin layer by layer of plastic, which immediately hardens to become these kinds of pieces. The pieces are then assembled by hand in a process that can take a number of hours, although we are making the designs easier and easier. And once assembled, these are then custom fit to the client, and the client can pick up a spoon. The client gets to pick up a cup, The client gets to be the coolest kid in the class, having previously been, you know, that odd kid with the funny hand. They love it. So that was a year ago. One of our members and I developed this Google Plus community, which has been growing by about 10% a week since we started it. We crossed the 1,000 member mark this week. A high school student created a Facebook page. Another member now maintains the website, which is our go-to place. It's called enablingthefuture.org. And we seem to have unleashed a virtual Cambrian explosion of innovative hand designs. This is the original MakerBot RoboHand, but in fact, it spawned the cyborg beast, which is what Shay has, and then Peregrine Hawthorne, which is his real name, is a 19-year-old who worked with his dad to produce this called the Talon Hand, which Peregrine, when he got his 2.0 Talon Hand, discovered that he was crushing a soda can while sitting at the bus station. And they are recombining like hybrid species, so we have a Talon Beast and, in fact, an Odie hand, which has three fingers for young Odysseus, a six-year-old in Greece, whose hand was too small. He needed something that would require less mechanical pressure. And indeed, the kids and the parents who are making these are becoming part of the design process as well. This is Luke Dennison. We call him Cool Hand Luke because his dad, Greg, who learned how to do 3D printing from another dad in our community, realized that he'd be better off with a thumb on each side of his hands. And it's not just the dads who are adding the design. This is Tully in North Carolina. Tully was asked, "What color would you like your hand?" He said, "Could it glow in the dark?" That is a really good idea. For that matter, 2 weeks ago, I sat down with young Derek, whose arm ends around here, and while I'm carefully explaining to him what we're working on, he took the demo model I had and another demo model that I had, and he put them together and he said, "I want mine to be this long." Also a good idea. Why shouldn't he be the kid who can reach to the top of the shelf where other kids can't? The kids love the fact that they look like toys. They give them superpowers. They love that part, but they're not actually toys. There was a piece on Fox News about a month ago in which Jose Delgado demonstrated his really cool $42,000 prosthetic arm, and he said, "Look, I can press this button and my fingers will open, and I can press this button and my fingers will close, but I like yours better," he said, "and ours costs about $20 in materials and is given to him for free." We now are taking e-NABLE tables to maker fairs to imagine our IT. We're developing hand-o-matic software for public libraries. Hand-o-matic software, you just put your hand up in front of the webcam, it takes some pictures, gives you measurements, gives you the model, and if there's a 3D printer there, you get your hand. And we are growing like crazy, and this is the point where you get to acquire the social disease as well. What you see here, hot off the presses, as we used to say in the print business, is the first active opening and closing prosthetic arm. We actually use some elbow motion, and I actually got to do some engineering for the first time, so there's just a little bit of cordage here that causes it to pull open as well as pull close. It's a little thing. But here's the big thing. This had to be made in three parts because our printer is not large enough for a grown-up-sized arm. There's a contest going on this week for a 2-foot by 2-foot arm-sized 3D printer. And if you look in the Flower City tweet stream, Twitter stream, you'll find that there's a link where you can press a button to vote for us so that we will win a $6,000 2-foot by 2-foot gigabot computer, and you too will have been inducted into the cult. If that's not your game, there's a lot more you can do. We are trying to organize. We have people who love 3D printers and don't particularly like people. There are people who love people and don't understand 3D printers. There are people who are organizing so that we can accept donations, about which I will be happy to entertain any questions you may have. We would like you to join us. Thank you very much.